Now Moses used to take a tent and pitch it outside the camp some distance away, calling it the tent of meeting. Anyone inquiring of the Lord would go to the tent of meeting outside the camp. And whenever Moses went out to the tent, all the people rose and stood at the entrances of their tents, watching Moses until he entered the tent. As Moses went into the tent, the pillar of cloud came down and stayed at the entrance while the Lord spoke with Moses. Whenever the people saw the pillar of cloud standing at the entrance to the tent, they all stood and worshipped, each at the entrance to his tent. The Lord would speak to Moses face to face as a man speaks with his friend. Then Moses would return to the camp, but his young aide Joshua, son of Nun, did not leave the tent. This is such a great passage. It's all about relationship. It's about a tent of meeting. It's about conversation, God speaking to Moses like a friend. It's about worship, and it's about God's presence. Becoming alive by relating to Him and to each other was the very thing God had freed His people for in the first place. So the last sentence is almost a side note, but very interesting. We meet this guy called Joshua, in Hebrew, Yeshua, meaning Yahweh is salvation. And he's kind of Moses' assistant, so he would follow him into the tent of meeting. But when Moses leaves, Joshua stays. So what does Joshua do in the tent? There's not much to do apart from just being with God, resting in God's presence, inhaling the Almighty, just hang out with Him. Joshua probably doesn't even know anything about God's plans for his future, and it's not even important at this point because he's not making any plans of how to conquer a foreign land. It's just about being with God. And by doing so, I believe God is shaping Joshua's heart and preparing him for some really cool things to come. So as I read parts of this passage again, think about how this whole situation in the tent might have felt for Joshua. What did he see? What did he feel? Why did he stay in the tent? The Lord would speak to Moses face to face as a man speaks with his friend. Then Moses would return to the camp, but his young aide Joshua, son of Nun, did not leave the tent. It's Advent, friends. It's a special time of the year, us anticipating the coming of Jesus. So why don't you take some time now to think about this? How could you, like Joshua, make some space to just rest in God's presence this Advent? We want to be with you. We need you to fill us. We need you to love us. We need you to prepare us to do whatever you want to do. We want to grow stronger in our relationship with you. Jesus, meet with us.